Grace Kids! Welcome to Grace Kids TV Junior!
Welcome back, friends! We are just about to get started. But first, if you're in class today and there are any toys on the ground, can you take the next 3 minutes to clean up and put everything away?
And once all the toys are cleaned up, you can come sit at a table and have a seat until we get started all together.
And if you're watching from home or somewhere else today, we're so happy you're joining us. We'll get started when the timer ends.
See you in just a little bit.
Grace Kids, welcome to church. My name is Scooter.
And my name is Stanley. We are so happy that you are joining Grace Kids for church today.
Before we get started with today's lesson, we wanted to review our three class rules to make sure that we have a safe and fun time in church today.
That's right. Our first rule is to always keep our fins and tails to ourselves.
Well, you have fins and a tail, Stanley, but our Grace Kids friends have arms and legs.
Oh, well, I guess you're right. So, our number one rule is to always keep our hands and feet to ourselves. Let's say that all together. Ready? Go!
Keep your hands and feet to yourself.
Great job! Our second rule in class is to always listen to your teacher.
That's right. Let's say that together too. Ready? Go!
Always listen to your teacher.
And finally, our last rule is to have fun. Let's all say, let's have fun all together. Ready? Go!
Let's have fun!
Way to go! We hope you have a lot of fun in class today, Grace Kids. And by following these three rules, we are going to have a great day together.
That's right! Well, I can't wait. Let's get started!
Let's go!
Jesus by standing up big and tall. Now, get ready, get set, and let's move by worshiping Jesus with singing and dancing.
Boys and girls, let's see if you can remember our memory verse this week. Good luck!
All right, Grace Kids. Your teacher will read a few words of your memory verse to you for the first time. For our first round, all you need to do is repeat after your teacher. Let's get started with round one. Your teacher will read first, then you repeat after them. Ready? Go. Time's up. For the next few rounds, we'll gradually take a few words away to see if you can still remember the entire memory verse. Now, your teacher will read the memory verse to you again, but there might be a few missing words. See if you can fill in the blanks to say the memory verse together. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go! Stop! Nice job. Now this time we're going to take even more words away. Let's see how you do. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go. Stop. Now we're going to take even more words away. As your teacher reads the memory verse, see if you can keep filling in all the missing words. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go! Stop. Get ready for the next round. We're taking even more words away this time. Let's see how you do. Good luck. 3, 2, 1, go. Stop. This is our last round. Let's see how you do. 3, 2, 1, go. Way to go, Grace Kids.
Ready for this week's real Bible story? Me too! Now remember, these are not just made-up stories. All stories we learn about in the Bible are real. So let's sit quietly at our table, keep your eyes on the TV, and let's see what we learn in this week's Bible story.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan,
and I am Jessie. Megan, look at the meal I made to share with everyone.
Ooh, yummy. What kind of food is this?
Well, it's a pretend meal. I made it with Play-Doh.
Oh, okay.
You know, because we don't eat Play-Doh.
Oh, right. Of course.
I made all my favorite foods. I made pizza and apple slices and pickles. But do you know the best part about a Play-Doh meal, Megan?
What's the best part, Jessie?
If you don't like pizza, apple slices, or pickles, you can just smash the dough and make whatever food you want.
That is a very good idea, Jessie. Our Bible story today is about a special meal that Jesus shared with his disciples.
Why was the meal special? Was it someone's birthday?
No, this meal was special because it was the last meal Jesus would have with his disciples. Jesus wanted the disciples to remember this special time together and the promises he made. Let's watch to learn more about the last meal Jesus shared with his disciples. Jesus and his disciples were in Jerusalem for a very special time, the Passover celebration, to remember how God had rescued his people from Egypt. This Passover, though, was the most special Passover because God was about to rescue his people again. This time, he would free people from the power of sin, and he had sent his own son to do the job. Jesus sent two of his disciples, Peter and John, into the city to get the Passover meal ready. He said, "You will meet a man carrying a jug of water. Follow him." Jesus said that the man would go to a house and the owner of the house would show Peter and John a large room upstairs where they could get the Passover meal ready. So Peter and John did as Jesus said. When the meal was ready, Jesus and his disciples sat around the table to eat. Jesus knew it was almost time to go back to his Father in heaven. Jesus said, "One of you will turn against me." The disciples were upset, but Jesus knew this was part of God's plan. Jesus ate the Passover meal with his disciples. While they ate, Jesus took the bread, broke it into pieces, and gave it to his disciples. He said, "Eat this. This bread is like my body that will be broken for you. Do this to remember me." Then he took the cup, thanked God for it, and gave it to his disciples. "Drink this," Jesus said. "This drink is like my blood. My blood makes the new covenant." After the meal, Jesus and his disciples sang songs and went to a mountain outside of the city. God's people had promised to love and obey God, but they broke their promise. God sent Jesus to make a new, even better promise. God would forgive people for their sins, and God would help them obey him.
Hi, Grace Kids. Now that we're watching this week's real Bible story, let's talk about it with our friends and with our teachers.
Raise your fins if you are ready for game time. Awesome, me too. Let's sit quietly now and check it out. Now let's sing our memory verse song to help us remember it.
La 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 la.
a high priest who has been tempted in every way as we are, yet without sin. Hebrews 4, verse 15.
For we have a high priest who has been tempted in every way as we are, yet without sin. For we have a high priest who has been tempted in every way as we are, yet without sin. Hebrews 4, verse 15.
Your fins if you are ready for game time. Awesome, me too. Let's sit quietly now and check it out.
Welcome to Spot the Difference. In just a moment, you'll see two images side by side. Your goal is to spot the three differences in the images. Ready? Let's begin. Round one. Can you spot the three differences? Time's up. Let's reveal the three differences. Round two. This one is a little harder. Can you spot the three differences? Time's up. Did you spot those three differences? Round three. This is the last one. Can you spot the three differences? Time's up. Let's reveal the three differences. Great job. Thanks for playing.
Oh, gross kids. Let's see what Miss Amanda has planned for this week's craft.
Hi, Grace Kids. I am super excited to do our craft today. All that you're going to need is this printout of a plate setting. It has a fork, the plate, a knife, and a spoon. And then you're going to need something to color with. So go ahead and get everything that you need, and I'm going to show you exactly how to decorate the plate setting. Are you ready? Okay, so all that you're going to do is color your plate setting, but you want to make it look really fancy because this meal that Jesus and his disciples prepared for was called the Passover meal. And Jesus sent two of his disciples to find a house where they could celebrate the Passover together. So you want to make this as super special as you can, and then you're going to take it home and use this to set the table for your family. So I'm going to use some of my favorite colors, and I'm going to try to color it really, really carefully so that it looks really special.
Thank you.
mentioned that my place setting is done, so I'm going to take this home and I'm going to try to set the table so that the fork is on my left side, the plate's in the middle, and then the knife and the spoon. And then that will be a super special meal that you could have with your family. I am super excited for you to decorate this place setting in class and for you to take it home to be able to have a special meal with your family. And please talk as a class about what you learned in the lesson and why we decorated a place setting. Why was this meal so important? I look forward to seeing your coloring, and I hope you have so much fun making this craft. Thanks so much for watching Grace Kids TV. Have a great week.
Grace Kids, we have had so much fun with you at church today.
We sure have. We did so many fun things together today.
We did. We learned a new Bible story, we played a fun game, we did a craft, and so much more!
Friends, if this was your first time joining Grace Kids today, we are so excited to be your new friend. All of our Grace Kids friends would love to say hi!
That's right! Just have a grown-up scan the QR code with their phone once it comes up on the screen so we can connect with your family.
Now, before we go, let's bow our heads and pray. Lord, we thank you for our time together in our Grace Kids class today. Thank you that we were able to learn a new Bible story today, spend time learning about God's Word, and having lots of fun. We pray that our Grace Kids friends can share what they learned today with their friends and family as they leave church today. Thank you for another great day at church. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. We hope you have a great week, Grace Kids, and we can't wait to see you next Sunday.
See you next week.
Grace Kids TV! Junior!